smartphone and I'll give you my first impressions on the same. So guys, as you can see, the Moto Z2 Force comes packaged in a red cardboard box, opening which you'll find the smartphone itself. Let me place that to the side for now. So guys, up next you'll find another slot for documentation. This also houses the SIM ejector tool, as you can see. I'm going to place this to the side as well. Okay guys, up next you'll find the wall charger. You'll also get a USB Type-C cable with the smartphone. And lastly, you'll also get a pair of in-ear type earphones. As you can see, these use a 3.5mm connector, but since the Moto Z2 Force does not ship with a headphone jack, you'll have to use this dongle which also comes bundled with the smartphone's packaging. Now guys, lastly, I would also like to mention that Motorola is also giving away this TurboPower battery mod with the Z2 Force on purchase of any Z2 Force actually. So what this does is, this basically acts as a power bank for your Moto Z2 Force, and it latches on to the back of the smartphone by means of these 16 pins you see here. So there's that also. That's it for the content of the box guys. Now let's take a closer look at the smartphone itself. So guys, now that we have the contents of the box out of the way, let's talk about the design of the Z2 Force. So as you can see, unlike most modern flagships, the Z2 Force does not ship with a bezel-less design, but it still manages to feel really premium. The smartphone comes with this brushed metal finish at the back, which you probably can't see right now, and it has a really sleek profile as well. So guys, what's even better is that the device is extremely rugged, as it comes with Motorola's Shatter Shield display technology, which basically adds a 5-layer system to the smartphone's display. So speaking of which, the Z2 Force comes equipped with a 5.5-inch Quad HD display, and as you can see, it has really good viewing angles and the text appears really sharp on the display too. The panel is Super AMOLED, so the colors will appear punchy and vibrant as well. So guys, in terms of port and button placement, you'll find the volume rockers as well as the power button towards the right side of the smartphone. Now the power button is textured so that you don't confuse between the two. Towards the back, you'll find the 16-pin connector, which is used to attach Moto mods to the device. There's nothing on the left spine of the smartphone. The bottom of the smartphone is reserved for a USB Type-C port, which is used to charge the device. Up top, you'll find a slot for a hybrid SIM tray, which can either house two SIM cards or a SIM card and a micro SD card. In terms of for fingerprint sensors, you'll find a fingerprint sensor present just below the display, and as you can see, it works really well. It's very quick and responsive, and in the brief time I used it, I found it to be extremely accurate as well. So guys, in terms of performance, the Moto Z2 Force is backed by a Snapdragon 835 processor, which works in tandem with 6GB of RAM and 64GB of expandable storage. So the 835 is currently the fastest processor in the market, so you shouldn't really expect any lags or stutters with the device. In terms of software, the Z2 Force boots a near stock version of Android Oreo and comes with a 2730mAh battery. So for optics, the Moto Z2 Force features a dual camera setup at the back comprising of a pair of 12MP sensors, one of which is a monochrome while the other is an RGB. So guys, the handset also comes with a 5MP shooter up front, which also comes with its own dedicated LED flash unit. So in terms of the camera app, it's a fairly stock camera app, and you can switch between different modes from here. As you can see, you also have the option of shooting in depth mode, so you'll be able to take those nice portrait shots with the Moto Z2 Force as well. So guys, on paper, the Z2 Force looks really promising, and it has something which no other smartphone can offer, which is support for modular accessories. But that said, we will be testing the smartphone extensively, so stay tuned for a full review to know if the Z2 Force is a good buy or not.